This is the second in our three-part series preseason videos. In this video, we're going to address participation requirements that must be fulfilled prior to student athletes stepping into the playing arena for practice. We will cover medical requirements, participation requirements, schools' responsibilities for participation, and amateur status. The health and safety of our student athletes is very important to us. On the health and safety page of the NCHSAA website, you will find detailed information about asthma, cardiac awareness, concussion, heat-related illness, neck injuries, sickle cell, and skin infection. Please take time to check out this information. We encourage you to contact the NCHSAA and speak with the health and safety consultant or any other staff member who may be able to offer assistance on these important topics. There are a few things to keep in mind as it relates to medical requirements for participation in NCHSAA athletics. First, a student must receive a medical examination once every 395 days by a duly licensed physician, nurse practitioner, or physician's assistant. Additionally, students absent from athletic practice for 5 or more days due to illness or injury shall receive a medical release by a physician licensed to practice medicine before readmittance to practice or contests. Now let's look at the rules and regulations regarding amateurism and amateur status in the NCHSAA. To maintain amateur status, a student must not accept money or awards having utilitarian value. That means golf balls, clubs, tennis rackets, and the like for participation in athletics. A student may accept an award, like a gift certificate or food coupon, for each sports season that does not exceed the value of $250. Additionally, to maintain amateur status, a student cannot have signed for a professional contract or played on a junior college or community college team. Next, here are a few helpful notes about students who are not eligible to participate in NCHSAA athletics. During the school year, a student may not play, practice, or be on the roster if ineligible. A student can participate in summer workouts if he or she is enrolled in the school, however, he or she must have a valid physical on file. Any falsification of this documentation makes the student ineligible for summer workouts. Now we'll look at member schools' responsibilities as it relates to student participation. There shall be no Sunday practice in any sport. This includes the assembling of athletic squads, whether it's full teams or selected individuals, for the purposes of viewing films, chalk talks, or other materials pertaining to the coaching of the team. A student may not dress for a game or scrimmage when he or she is not eligible to participate in the game. If a student is ejected, he or she may be in the bench area, but may not be in uniform while serving the penalty time. If a coach is ejected, he or she may not be on the premises during the contest and is not allowed to communicate with the coaches or team during the contest. Later in this video series, we'll talk more about ejections and the consequences for both student athletes, coaches, and schools. Athletic directors must submit an eligibility summary form that is verified by the principal for each sports season. The master eligibility sheets are to be shared with each member school of your conference for each sport program. Finally, there must be a mandatory parent or guardian meeting to have parents and students sign the eligibility and authorization statement to acknowledge that eligibility, sportsmanship policies, and expectations have all been reviewed. Wrapping up the section on school responsibilities, please note that schools must pay their catastrophic insurance fees by October 1. Non-payment of fees by the deadline makes all teams at that school ineligible for NCHSAA playoffs. Schools must pay their membership dues, which are calculated by the average daily membership or ADM numbers, by December 1. Non-payment of fees by the deadline makes all teams at that school ineligible for NCHSAA playoffs, beginning with winter sports. In closing, students and schools both have medical and participation requirements for each student athlete participating in sports. The school also has NCHSAA responsibilities for continued membership with the NCHSAA that is required annually.